Listening Library presents Hitler Youth, Growing Up in Hitler's Shadow by Susan Campbell Bartoletti. Read for you by Kathrin Kana, with a foreword and an author's note, read by the author.
This is Susan Campbell Bartoletti. This is not a book about Adolf Hitler. This book is about the children and teenagers who followed Hitler and the National Socialist or Nazi Party during the years 1933 to 1945. These are the 12 years of the Third Reich, a regime that changed history and the world forever. This book is the story of the millions of boys and girls who belonged to the Hitler Youth and bore the name proudly. At a time when Germany was suffering from a weak, unstable government, high unemployment, and widespread poverty, the Nazi Party promised young Germans a great future in a great Germany if they joined the Hitler Youth. Formed officially in 1926, the Hitler Youth offered its members excitement, adventure, and new heroes to worship. It gave them hope, power, and the chance to make their voices heard. And for some, it provided the opportunity to rebel against parents, teachers, clergy, and other authority figures. Adolf Hitler admired the natural energy and drive that young people possess. He understood that young people could be a powerful political force that could help shape Germany's future. In his quest for power, Hitler harnessed their enthusiasm and loyalty. "I begin with the young," said Hitler. "We older ones are used up, but my magnificent youngsters, are there finer ones anywhere in the world? Look at all these men and boys. What material! With them, I can make a new world." Hitler counted on Germany's boys and girls. This is their story.
The young people in this book. Alfons Heck. Alfons Heck was born in 1928 in Wittlich, a small Rhineland village in western Germany. At age 10, Alfons attended the Nazis' Nuremberg rally, where he listened, spellbound, as Adolf Hitler spoke. In 1944, at the young age of 16, Alfons commanded more than 800 Hitler Youth. As the Allied forces closed in, he led Hitler Youth and others in the defense of Germany. Helmut Hübner. Helmut Hübner was born in 1925 in Hamburg, Germany. 16-year-old Helmut and his two best friends, Karl Schnibbe and Rudi Wobbe, broke the German radio law, which forbade Germans from listening to foreign radio stations. When Helmut realized that the Nazis were lying to the German people, he printed anti-Nazi leaflets that passed on the foreign news to others, a crime punishable by death under Nazi law. Dagobert Bert Levin. In 1923, Dagobert Bert Levin was born in Berlin, Germany. As a Jew, he suffered humiliation and persecution at the hands of the Nazis and the Hitler Youth. Bert was 18 when his parents were deported to a death camp in 1942, leaving him to work as a forced laborer for the Nazis in a Berlin munitions factory. Milita Maschmann. In 1918, Milita Maschmann was born in Berlin, Germany. When Hitler came to power, her parents forbade her to join the Bund Deutscher Mädel, or BDM, the girls' branch of the Hitler Youth. Convinced that Adolf Hitler and the Nazi Party would better Germany, 15-year-old Milita disobeyed her parents and sneaked out to weekly BDM meetings. Henry Mittelmann. Born in 1922, Henry Mittelmann lived in the small town of Altona, near Hamburg, in northwest Germany. Despite his father's disapproval, he joined the Hitler Youth. When war broke out in 1939, 16-year-old Henry was eager to fight. He became a tank driver and saw action in France, Russia, Poland, and Austria. Herbert Norkus. Herbert Norkus was born in 1916 and lived with his father and younger brother in Moabit, an impoverished Berlin neighborhood. His mother forbade him to join the Hitler Youth, but after her death in 1931, 14-year-old Herbert joined. He campaigned to get Nazis elected to office. Karl-Heinz Schnibbe. Karl-Heinz Schnibbe was born in 1924 in Hamburg, Germany. He thought the Hitler Youth sounded like a great deal of fun, so he joined eagerly when the Nazis enlisted eligible boys in his neighborhood. However, he soon tired of the rules and discipline. With his two best friends, Helmut Hübner and Rudi Wobbe, Karl protested the Nazi regime. Elisabeth Vetter. Elisabeth Vetter was born in 1931 and attended a Catholic school in Rötz, a village in southeastern Germany, near the Czechoslovakian border. When Elisabeth was 8, her mother and father scolded her for her loyalty to Adolf Hitler. Elisabeth told her Hitler Youth leaders on her parents, an action that led to their arrest. Rudolf Rudi Wobbe. Rudolf Rudi Wobbe was born in 1926 in Hamburg, Germany. Along with Karl Schnibbe and Helmut Hübner, 15-year-old Rudi listened to foreign radio broadcasts and distributed anti-Nazi leaflets. Inge, Hans, and Sophie Scholl. The Scholl children lived with their parents in Ulm, a small town near Stuttgart in southern Germany. The oldest, Inge Scholl, was born in 1917 and was 16 when Adolf Hitler came to power. Inge and her two brothers and two sisters joined the Hitler Youth eagerly, despite their father's misgivings. Inge's younger brother Hans Scholl, born in 1918, commanded a unit of 150 boys, but soon rebelled against the conformity and loss of individual rights. Hans's younger sister Sophie Scholl shared his feelings. Born in 1921, Sophie loved Germany, but also detested the lost freedoms under the Nazi regime. While students at the University of Munich, Hans and Sophie joined with others in a dangerous campaign against Hitler, the Nazis, and the war. Introduction. The Bloody Handprint. The Murder of Herbert Norkus. Sunday, January 24th, 1932. It was a typical, raw, dark, wintry morning in Moabit, a drab industrial section of Berlin, the capital of Germany. It was early, not yet 5 o'clock, but 15-year-old Herbert Norkus was already up, hurriedly dressing. Herbert buttoned the brown shirt of his Hitler Youth uniform and slipped the swastika armband onto his forearm. He grabbed his winter coat and soft, peaked brown trench cap before rushing out of the service quarters on the factory grounds where he lived with his father and younger brother. His father worked as a stoker at the factory, barely earning enough to make ends meet. His mother had died the year before after a long illness. Herbert belonged to the Hitlerjugend, or Hitler Youth, an organization of teenagers dedicated to Adolf Hitler. Hitler was the leader of the rising National Socialist Party, known as the Nationalsozialistische Deutsche Arbeiterpartei, or Nazis for short. Mrs. Norkus had forbidden Herbert to join the Hitler Youth, calling it too dangerous. But she had feared the communists, or Reds, even more. She warned Herbert to keep himself distant from the Reds, said Gerhard Mont, a Hitler Youth leader. Bloody street fights often erupted between the Nazis and the communists. But after Mrs. Norkus died in 1931, Herbert's father relented and gave his son permission to join the Hitler Youth. Mr. Norkus believed that the Hitler Youth would be good for Herbert, especially after his mother's death. He hoped that the group would lift his son's spirits, help him make new friends, and instill a sense of discipline in him. It did. On weekends, Herbert and the Hitler Youth hiked and camped in the countryside. with the Marine Jungschar, the naval branch of the Hitler Youth, Herbert boated on the waters in Tetlow Park in eastern Berlin. Herbert also enjoyed distributing leaflets throughout the Berlin neighborhoods. The Propagandablitz, as the Hitler Youth called it, spread information about the Nazi Party. It was dangerous work, but Herbert took the Nazis' creed of self-sacrifice seriously. That morning, as Herbert passed the crumbling brick tenement buildings and treeless courtyards, he watched out for Reds. There was no telling when a Red might jump out of nowhere to pick a fight. More than once, Herbert had escaped serious injury by outwitting or outrunning his attackers. Quick on his feet.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.